It's game two of the Eastern Conference Finals. And again tonight, we come to you from the United Center in Chicago on Madison Street for the second game in the best of seven series. Most of those gathered here are not hungry, and they are Bulls fans. It's game two of the 1997 Eastern Conference Finals between the Miami Heat and the Chicago Bulls. And good evening, everybody. Welcome back to Chicago, where again tonight, Miami hopes to accomplish something they've yet to do, win a playoff game against Chicago. They're 7-0 in three playoff series. I'm joined, as always, by Doc Rivers. Doc, Miami played very well the other night. Where do they need to improve tonight?
Well, Vernie, they have to improve on offense. On defense, they were happy. The Bulls only scored 84 points, but Miami only scored 77. Miami must run the basketball. They have to get into their transition game. Tim Hardaway, they need him to get into the open court so he can explore. They have one huge problem, and that is they have to get the rebound first. Chicago had 20 offensive rebounds. Dennis Rodman had 7 by himself. The only way you're going to run is you have to get the ball first.
The Bulls won the title a year ago. They're 8-1 in the playoffs now. Let's quibble a bit. They have gotten off to slow starts in several games.
Well, we have to find something. They're winning everything else right now. They have. They've struggled early in every game. They've fallen behind. And they're a little worried about their offense. 84 points is not enough for them. Scottie Pippen, Michael Jordan, they were great. They've scored points, but they need help from their bench, and that has not come. The bench was 3-for-22 in game one. They need help from either Tony Kukoc, Steve Kerr, or Brian Williams. If they can get that, they're in good shape.
Well, it's not only a battle between the number one and two seeds in the East. It is a battle between two future Hall of Fame coaches. This is the fifth playoff meeting between Pat Riley and Phil Jackson. Phil Jackson has had the edge. He has won 3 of the series to 1 for Riley. And they have been competing for almost 3 decades. We'll take you back, in this case, to the early 70s. And if you're not sure, that's Jackson on the left and Riley on the right. You got to admit, times were cool then, man. Game two of the 1997 NBA playoffs, the Lake Shore of Lake Michigan. And about 2 miles to the west on Madison Street, the United Center. Inside, among the 24,000, is our colleague, Rick Sigmund.
Well, experience in past playoffs was definitely a factor in Game 1, helping the Bulls maintain their poise despite a 16-point deficit. It is now up to Miami to make adjustments. The player whom they turn to is Dan Marley. 9 years in the league, 9 years in the playoffs. And earlier today, we discussed tonight's focus.
I think we had to do a better job rebounding. We got out rebounded by 20-plus boards, especially on their offensive end. We can't let them get second and third shots. We had to do a better job to keep the Rodman and those guys off the boards. And then do a better job on Michael and Scottie. They're going to get their points, but we got to make sure that we limit what they do easily. We got to make sure they work for their points and then make them work defensively.
No one can guard Michael Jordan one-on-one. If you're asked to tonight, what's it like for those of us who never have that opportunity? What's it like to guard Michael?
Well, you just go out there and do your best. You can't stop that guy. Obviously, he takes too many shots. He's too good for his team to stop him. Just try to make it work. You try to get a hand in his face and make him take tough shots and hope that he's missing that night. And then I think you got to limit what the other guys do. But, he's unstoppable.
Not having the home court advantage, how important is it for you guys to win tonight's game?
It'd be great for us to come out here and get a victory. If not, we got to go home and take care of business and then try to get a win the next time we're in Chicago. But we'd love to come out and play well and get the victory here. I mean, we got to come out sometime and get a win here. Might as well be tonight.
For Dan Marley, his career playoff game number 100 against Michael Jordan and the Bulls here on TNT.
Playoffs on TNT, brought to you by Cool Refresh Budweiser. Reminds you, fresh beer tastes better. By Jeep, makers of the Jeep Grand Cherokee, Cherokee, and Wrangler. By Domino's Pizza, for up and by for Domino's now. And by AT&T, it's on in your
And the second starting lineup for game two from Chicago for Miami, Hardaway and Leonard in the backcourt. DJ Brown on one. And for Chicago, it'll be Jordan and Juan Harper, Dennis Rodman, Longley, and Scottie Pippen. And let's check in with Craig Sager once again.
Well, earlier we showed the collision between Dennis Rodman and the Ron's a warning 2 days ago. Zoe is still in severe pain. So much so that Ron Cope, the trainer, sent for 8 different types of vest protection to wear in his chest. He even talked to the Miami Dolphins about a flak jacket. The one he selected, we tried to show you, but it's under tight security, but it's like a belt that goes across his chest, held in by Velcro, heavily padded. It allows him to breathe, does not restrict his movement, but still it could be bothersome for Zoe tonight.
Okay, Craig, thank you. You buying that?
I don't know about the vest. I think they have kryptonite in it to try to stop Superman Jordan from doing it.
The officiating crew tonight, Bill Oakes, Steve Jabby, and Vernie Fryer.